Welcome back to round 3 of the Modern 2K series today. And in today's feature match, we have Tahir Taladia on Naya Burn against Gavin Berger on a spicy Mardu tokens list. Or rather, a foil Mardu tokens list. And this match is... like, truth be told, I have no idea how this match is going to go. Generally, black-white tokens is a really hard match for Burn. But, like... there's another color in this deck.
It's Mardu tokens.
There's also Monastery Mentor and Young Pyromancer. So
it's actually, it looks like a pretty interesting list.
I mean, it plays Lightning Bolt. I can get behind any deck that plays Faithful Push, Lightning Bolt, and Secure the Wastes. I mean, Secure the Wastes is one of my favorites from Standard. I played it in Modern a couple of times. It seems okay. It's not super powerful, but when it works, it's really, really good. Tahir's list, also unconventional. I mean, I don't see any Goblin Guides, Wild Nakatals. I do see a Tarkus Command, Lightning Helix, Boros Charm. I see 4 Shard Volleys, not caring about lands here. 1 mana or bust, it seems. And 1 Flames of the Blood Hand. Interesting card. Fell out of favor recently because it costs 4 mana. And with the addition of Tarkus Command, you don't really need additional ways to stop life gain.
Well, I think it's going to be interesting. I guess if Gavin gets a couple of tokens out, gets an engine going, I mean, all the burners going to have to go to his face anyway.
The difference between this and, say, black-white tokens is he's not playing Audio Champion, so Bitter Blossom could kill him. He could die to his own Bitter Blossom pretty easily. And also, Audio Champion is a nightmare for burn because proc red.
Yeah.
And it looks like players are about to start. We'll transition. So, die roll. You see 3 as the roll. I think this is the first time we've actually managed to catch half of a die roll. I'd assume Gavin won there. If he didn't, that's really unlucky. And we'll see who starts first. We'll actually take a look at the hands. Gavin with Inquisition, Lightning Bolt, Sacred Foundry, looks like possibly Lingering Souls, and I believe a Sorin. Tahir.
Some burn stuff.
Yeah, I mean, I play burn, deck is pretty good, but a lot of the damage comes from having either Goblin Guide, Wild Nakatl, or Swift Spear.
Just having the early hits.
There are times where you have to just burn your opponent to death, but... those times are generally you fighting to burn your opponent to death.
Okay, Gavin did mulligan.
Okay, so we can't actually see Tahir's hand. I believe it's 3 lands and a Tarkus Command. And if you would stop closing it, I could see more. Swift Spear. And possibly a Lightning Bolt.
I guess we'll have to see.
And Gavin scryed away. He has kept this hand of
Lingering Souls.
Mandland, Lingering Souls, Inquisition.
He fetches?
That's an expedition.
Yes. This is basically Sean Capes's collection of cards,
expect to see lots of foils, expeditions, promos. If it's valuable, you will see it. If it's not valuable, I don't know why it's there. I mean, like, possibly Young Pyromancers, or like maybe Monastery's Mentor isn't all foil.
Okay, he goes bolt to the face. It's helping Tahir out here.
Well, he is probably going to seize against Burn after this Inquisition.
Probably decide, like, feel his life choices here is going to be pretty
I think
shot.
He actually took Tahir for playing maybe a flash deck, blue, red, or blue, white, red.
So it is a bolt, a Tarkus Command. Oh!
It was a Grim Lavamancer, not a Swift Spear, my bad.
And a Boros Charm.
I think you should probably take the Boros Charm here. Deal 4 damage for 2 mana. Most efficient burn spell in the deck. There are actually games where if you don't see Boros Charm, you won't win.
Yeah, I think you just take it.
tossing it in the pit in his own hand. Not sure if he can actually deal with Lavamancer, and that does provide a lot of damage throughout the game.
Well, look, I mean, he's got a lot of spot removal spells. He doesn't have any in his hand, as far as I could see, but...
The other thing is, Toyota has no one mana spell besides Rift Bolt, so I think he has taken Rift Bolt, actually.
Yeah.
So, yeah, taking the Rift Bolt, because it's going to be hard onto his mana. And we're more than likely going to see Toyota go to 17 this turn. Almost certainly fetching Sacred Foundry.
There it is. And yeah.
And we will see Grim Lavamancer. That is a young Pyromancer. I don't believe he wants to play it without having another spell.
It's way too early for that. He really wants to get some value off, although, especially with a burn.
Like, that Lavamancer is going to be a real pain to deal with him playing 4 Pyros and 2 Monastery Mentors, because it's going to kill the creatures without having to use extra cards.
Yeah, suspending the Rift Bolt.
So he top decked another one.
Well, seeing he's got the 2, so probably he's not going to use it early. If that like young Pyromancer comes out, it's pretty much dead, so we'll not see that.
And he just top decked another Pyro.
Gets more. Ugh. So does he bait it?
You could tell me it's worth baiting it. I don't think it is. I also would not path this Lavamancer anytime soon.
Fetches. Basic planes.
I mean, going you have to fetch route. Basics in this type of match.
Yes.
Sometimes you can lose just by shocking one too many times. Generally, it's pretty easy to deal 12 damage. And Toyo's head actually has 7 points of burn in it. And okay, we're going to see the young Pyro. Is Toyo going to respond by burning it? He'll probably then be pathed away and he'll get an elemental.
He does a push.
Oh,
that's
push.
Even better.
That's better than
Fatal Push, much better. Go, exile, target. Get a token, lose the Pyromancer.
If he had Path, I may have even Pathed my own Pyromancer at that point.
Maybe.
Because you end up getting the token anyway. The Lavamancer would require more cards in the yard, and you ramp yourself up. 3 to Gavin, obviously. I don't see a point in dealing 3 damage to a 1-1.
He's got Lava Spike. Probably going with that straight away. No reason not to. He still has Zabara's Charm in hand, so he can just do that end of turn. He's got the Tarkus Command and...
Looks like a Shard Volley.
And Shard Volley. I think that's pretty much enough damage there.
Well, he's missing a green source. And his opponent has a man land that...
True, true.
Gains life.
Takes one.
So if Toyo top takes a land, he would win on the spot. Or rather a sack land. Let me specify, it must be a green source.
And there's the Boros Charm, 4 to the face.
Or if he top takes a Boros Charm or any burn spell, he just wins. And it's a Boros Charm.
Boros Charm. 4 and...
Shard Volley. Game.
Shard Volley. Game.
On to game 2.
Okay, so... Sideboards are... Actually... there's, yeah, timely reinforcements. That's great. That's
okay.
Thing.
So, looking at Gavin's sideboard, we have timely reinforcements. Bless the Lions. I mean, that's all I see you want to bring in.
Yeah, just get some life gain.
Someone can make an argument for Radiant Flames or Anger of the Gods. He would not be convincing me.
I don't think so. It's like he's playing the tokens matchup here. It's like I don't even see why that is really in his sideboard.
Well, Anger of the Gods is mainly to deal with cards in Dredge. Not that Dredge is a deck anymore, but sometimes maybe Abzan Coco, you want to exile everything.
Yeah, I guess, okay, like if...
I don't know why Radiant Flames is there. Unless he like really wants to deal one damage to everything when his creatures are powered up. In which case, Electricity would be better because you can just...
overload.
Deal one damage and overload.
Yeah, like it's...
But okay, we're not yet to discuss this sideboard, so we have to discuss what they would bring in.
Well, that's for him it's easy, it's the life gain.
And for Tahir, Destructive Revelry.
Well, he doesn't know, he hasn't seen anything happen. He saw a young Pyromancer, he has no idea what he's facing.
Okay, so pro tip, playing against a white deck, always bringing Destructive Revelry. Why? They could have Leyline and you lose on the spot, immediately. Without fail.
Other than that,
I'd probably bring in Skullcrack.
Skullcrack would be, well, a crack here.
I mean, I don't see the need to have the Flame of the Blood Hand main board. I also probably don't want as many Shard Volleys. I do think Searing Blood is better in this match. I'm surprised he doesn't have any Searing Blazes. Maybe doesn't have them. Those are generally better than Searing Blood. Kinda don't like Eidolon too much in this match. I mean, it's fine.
That's okay. I mean, it's gonna hurt them both most of the time. Looking at these lists, it's actually gonna be pretty good. I think you should keep it in, like,
I suppose, yeah, okay, his opponent actually doesn't have access to Core Firewalker or... Okay, so because his opponent's list is not built to deal with burn like Black White Tokens is, Eidolon is fine. And so is Swift Spear.
Yeah. What he takes out though is...
It's definitely Flames of the Blood Hand. I do not believe he should have 4 Shard Volley even in his 75.
Yeah. Well,
maybe 1. You can make an argument for 1, but like 4.
Well,
I mean, it's there. I would cut them personally. If he leaves it in, I would not be surprised. But I think that's what I'm cutting. I'm cutting Shard Volley, I'm cutting Flames of the Blood, and on the play, I think everything else is fine. Possibly don't want Lightning Helix on the play, but if you're going to try and race, you kind of need it.
Yeah.
I do think your opponent's playing white, you have to bring in the Cycle of Revelry. What number, that's up to you entirely, and also depends what you're taking out.
Well, I mean, he's running 4 on the sideboard, which is... excessive. If he is getting like or expecting a lot of ley lines, then
okay, what makes it worse is he's running 4 Smash the Shmivarines in the same.
True.
So he's like really going to hate Affinity. Like Affinity will have no game against that deck.
Which is quite interesting because I don't think we have any Affinity lists here today.
Yeah, Hamza not being here today. Only Affinity player in the top 16, I believe.
Yes. As far as I know.
And, well, I believe Tide has mulled. Gavin has kept his 7. We'll be playing first. Okay, Tide hasn't mulled, it's just Gavin being a bit too fast. Try and have a look at Gavin's hand. See the young Pyromancer again. Not a fan of that card after the banned Kid Probe.
Yeah, I've never really been a fan of it. I mean it does some stuff, let's be honest, but does it do enough?
Even in Grixis Delver doesn't always do enough. It's probably one of the weaker cards in that deck, to be honest with you. And without Cataxian Probe you don't get extra value from it, which makes it even worse. And Gavin is down to 19. Inquisition is going to see Boros Charm.
Are you born in the Revelry?
Destructive Revelry. Lava Spike. I didn't see Gavin's hand, but if he has any number of intangible virtue or Butter Blossom, you take Revoltia. Personally, I think Butter Blossom's really dodgy in this match.
Yeah,
I think and by really dodgy, I mean suicidal.
Well, he ran it as a 4 of, so, like, do you think he took it out?
On the play, I would maybe keep them in. On the draw, I would always take them out. Just for this match. Especially since he doesn't have Aurea Champion to gain life when he
to reset
the battlefield.
Okay, Gavin writing down some cards.
We didn't mention what Gavin would take out, but on his side, I would probably take out Zealous Persecution. It's a bit too narrow against Burn when the majority of the creatures have 2 toughness. And the other cards I would take out probably be Bitter Blossom, surprisingly, because on the play you want Inquisition, not so much on the draw. And you kind of want Fatal Push.
Really you bad. Always want Fatal Push.
Possibly Mentor is bad in this matchup. I mean, coming out to turn later than Young Pyromancer and also dying to the same cards in Burn, not ideal. And Gavin is on 60. Should not miss that.
Another fetch land, which is not surprising as he runs a ton. What is that? 7, 9 fetches.
I mean, his mana is kind of hard.
It is actually really tough.
For me, though, I would probably play maybe Dark Confidant in this list, as opposed to Young Pyromancer, and then Aurea Champions, try and attack from that angle. In which case, I probably wouldn't splash red, though.
Yeah, then you just take out the red, and then you're back at the black-white tokens.
There's nothing wrong with black-white tokens. It's a bit boring, but other than that, it's consistent most of the time. Has good games against certain decks, most of which are
well,
anger
ones. Like this has been working today. I mean, he is 2-0 up.
That I think it's more surprise factor, to be honest with you. I mean, I can see the strengths of the deck by splashing dead. I just don't like Young Pyromancer at the moment. Personal opinion. He does have Westfall Abbey in his deck, which is... I mean, if you flip a Westfall Abbey, can you lose in Modern? Yes, they can path it. Never mind.
Yeah, they actually have a very efficient spell for it.
I mean, you could get Vapor Snagged in Modern, for all we care. I mean, it's a standard powerhouse, don't get me wrong.
4 down.
If you've ever seen Westfall Abbey playing Green Black and flips against you on turn 4, you start crying inside. Because you can't race that.
There is no way.
I think Todd has Lightning Helix.
He has Helix, which is interesting.
I think he may want to Helix the Spyro. Or he may want to just go to his face.
Down to 11.
I see Godless Shrine tapped, fixing his mana. I'm surprised that's not an expedition. Suppose you can't have 4 expeditions of everything.
Can't have them all.
I suppose if Sean had the choice, he probably would have them all.
Well, let's see. He goes... He's got Lingering Souls. Interesting.
I mean, he's going to cast Lingering Souls and get 3 creatures. That's a lot of value.
And that was Timely Reinforcements, I believe. Oh, no, it's not.
I think it's just another Lingering Souls.
Just another Lingering Souls.
I mean, we say just, but...
Well,
3
I mean,
mana, 3 creatures with flashback. 2 mana, 3 creatures. In this board state.
There it is.
So I'm just thinking, how does Zoid win this game? It's he Lightning Helix is now. He top decks Boros Charm. I think he has. I believe. It looks like he has lands in hand.
Yeah, he's only got that one spell. The rest seem to be lands. Using it, gaining some life.
So he basically goes up one to 21. He goes down one to 20. Gavin goes down eight to 8. So he has to top deck two Boros Charms in a row and he's already seen two of them.
He's gonna have a rough time. I mean, his clock is still fine. I mean, he's taking 5 a turn at this stage. It's gonna just get more. Like, maybe he has 3 turns to get 3 burn spells?
I don't think he has 3 turns to get 3
burn spells. Well, this is his first one now coming up, his first draw. Then.
But playing against tokens, I've played against before, not with burn.
Oh, wow. Is that good? It's Eidolon.
I think Eidolon's fine.
It's safe.
Unless Gavin rips a sword in which case Eidolon's not fine. But in which case, I think Toyed loses on the spot.
Yeah, I think if he gets a Sorin now and plays it, just go to game 3.
I mean, even Intangible Virtue is pretty good here. I would probably take 2 for that. Yeah, I would probably go to 6 for an Intangible Virtue. Nothing else, though.
Well, I think the Eidolon then just kind of chumps. He has to only go in with the Flyers.
He can go into Pyro. If I'm Gavin, I don't mind trading Young Pyromancer for Eidolon.
He takes another one.
Oh. Is he going to get a basic though? And then maybe attempt to fatal push. Okay, so we can play tapped.
And
Kevin's like still in a really rough spot. Like, with Eidolon in the field, Toyed does have 3 turns to find Bone Spells. He's gonna need 2, though.
And
it is a sword.
Making the best days better. Yeah, that Life Swing is gonna finish it.
Yeah, go to game 3, guys.
It's like,
don't try and fight this. Unless you have a Skullcrack, which we know you don't try and fight this.
Okay, plus, swing in with a team.
I think he can attack with Elemental, I don't think he wants to attack with a Pyro.
I think he wants to actually protect it, so if the Eidolon dies,
Gavin
if it blocks.
Is going up to 13 here. I don't think there's any way.
It happens. 13, and so you're down to
14. So, in my opinion, Toy is just sort of trying to see what else Gavin's playing in terms of sideboard cards here.
Does he even?
Top deck, what is it? That looks like a not good card. Not that anything would be good at this point.
Yeah, I don't think he's got any outs here. The life swing is just too much. If he had a removal spell for the Pyromancer, like it wouldn't even have helped because it's just 6 more life next turn.
Gavin actually just top deck the bolt. It would be pretty funny if the burn player dies to the tokens player via bolt.
Shoot.
Okay, so we're actually just seeing
it slowly happen. Gavin takes his 2.
The 2 is not relevant at this point.
Not at all. gets his token.
Lingering Souls.
More Lingering Souls. He wants them out before he activates that Sorin. Not that it makes a difference either. Ah, that looks so painful.
I mean, maybe that's why he won his first two rounds, because his opponent loses to Sorin.
That is 9.
Up to 20. What even?
Skullcrack. Take 3. Gain no life. Down to 8.
Wow. Unfortunately, though, he can't throw 2 bird spells this time.
That was, like, if that was just the previous turn, it would have been great.
Well, not necessarily, because I'm sure Gavin would block with his Pyro to save a Sorin.
Alright, so
back to the drawing board we go. I don't think there's any changes sideboard wise to make on Gavin's side. Unless he didn't bring in Breast Alliance timely reinforcements.
Yeah.
On Toya's side, on the draw, Eidolon is not very good. Especially when your opponent is trying to race you and gains life.
Well, okay, so we know he got both the Skullcrack and the Revelry in, so that happened.
We might see Surgical Extraction this game.
Is it? It has worth,
because basically if he sees Lingering Souls in the yard, he can just exile all the Lingering Souls.
Yes, that's actually in this matchup very good, but very narrow.
It's very narrow, but also, if somehow he kills a Sorin once, he can just exile the rest of them. Young Pyromancer, same thing. The majority of his opponent's threats are all 4-ops.
True.
Whereas, he kind of doesn't want any of his creatures. I mean, Swift Spear is fine. He's going to be on the play this round. Lavamancer, it kills everything that matters and things that don't. So I'm fine with Lavamancer. I don't know if he wants Eidolon. He is on the play. I think being on the play, you could want Eidolon, but your opponent's really trying to race you.
I think he needs to up his...
I'm still not seeing Shard Volley. I think he wants Searing Blood. I don't know if he took them out. Flames of the Blood Hand, and it is, I still don't know why it's there. Why is it there? I don't know. It could just have been a Skullcrack. One less mana.
Maybe...
Cut Shard Volley. That's all I'm saying.
You really don't like that card.
It's not that I don't like that card, it's that I don't like 4 of them, because in Burn, you will sometimes keep the 1 lander, in which case, that is the worst card you can have in your hand.
Sure.
And while we're waiting for players to resolve sideboarding...
Gavin's already mulliganed.
No, I think they're still... siding?
I'm almost certain
they're still siding. Because Tahir is still taking stuff out of his deck box and putting it into his deck. So.
Yeah, Tahir has been like one out, one in for a while.
Yeah.
There's not 2 going in again.
Okay, well, they're busy sideboarding. So we'll have a reminder again that Modern Masters 2017 is on sale and you can pre-order. I believe it's 3,799? 38. Stocks unlimited. You can check it on the site, www.luckshack.co.za.
That's the one. Yeah, and that's on the feature page, so should be easy to spot. So I was looking at the standings earlier, and I realized with everyone that's actually here today, looking at it last week, we said everyone down to 21 had a chance. That is no longer the case.
I believe it's up until like 17th.
Only 17th, which was Jonathan Tippin. He is now 2 up. Going to his third game, playing against Philip Franken, actually, so playing against Infect. He's
on one of the most interesting lists we have here today, actually. Bane in the Jar, with Breaking and Entering, alongside Karizev's Expertise and Dorks, basically. So that will hopefully be on the future match. We decided not to put it on against Infect, because that would be either super one-sided or breaking Magic, and I didn't want to really comment on that after the last game, to be honest with you.
But yeah, so if he, I think if he wins another one, he should be locked up for 16th, because current number 16, if you go to our list, Morgan Palace is not here today. Yes. Like I said, everyone else is. It is pretty much locked up. Top 4 even is.
I mean, the top 4 was safe.
Yeah, top 4 is already safe. I mean, Shad being number 1, not even playing today. Hamza not even playing today. But
I mean, realistically, we could have had 7 rounds and Shad would be safe at number 1.
Sure, sure.
He is 7 points ahead of the next highest. And now we are waiting to see if players are going to accept their hands. And we'll have a look. I mean, Gavin is thinking hard.
He's okay.
I think he's fine.
So he's starting. Is it some damage? Probably is.
It isn't, because Toyota isn't playing Goblin Guide. So his only one drop that will really have matter is Swift Spear. Grim Lovermancer turn 1 is fine sometimes.
And it goes off. Gavin's
17.
17. Draws a Lovermancer. Probably goes for it.
That is shocking. Absolutely shocking. They are mismatched mountains on the table. Someone call a judge. That should be disqualified.
Okay, Gavin taking another hit, down to 16. At least now he knows not to be too aggressive with his fetches.
Yeah, I mean, game 1 he was dead regardless of whether that first one had been a shock or not, to be honest with you.
Yeah. Unfortunately, didn't get to see his hand, so we can't even speculate on what he's hoping to play
next.
I have
a feeling it's going to be Pyromancer again.
Well, it's
this time it's really bad, though.
Yeah, this is probably the worst place for it to be at this stage.
I'm surprised there's no Lightning Helix in Gavin's list. I mean, those are full art as well, so wouldn't be surprised if Sean picked those up. He is going to pass turn.
Indeed he is.
Lightning Bolt.
Lightning Bolt.
And yeah, if we had seen Pyromancer, we'd die to the Lavamancer. Clearly lava better than fire at this point.
That's not work. I think this is actually going to be a very quick game. There's a Helix as well, which is quite swingy. He can just sit on that for a while.
Actually, Tide has 2 lands in hand and a Helix, so
yeah. Well, okay, and he also, his mana is all wrong. He does not have white, or he didn't play white. Why would he do that? Is it really that bad?
I didn't see the lands, but I believe one was not a sac land. I think it was another stomping ground.
Sure, sure. So he is actually just hoping to draw into something that does stuff.
So yeah, it's multiple copies of Stomping Ground in his hand. That is...
Where's the Atarkus Command when you need it?
Atarkus Command wouldn't be that good here. I mean, it's fine, but in a deck that plays as few creatures as he does, it becomes a bit weaker. And while we were busy looking at the hands, we'll switch to board state. Because now it's changing. There will be Lingering Soul tokens.
Do you think he just eats the one?
I mean, if I'm on Gavin's side of the table, I would believe that...
That's the plan.
Toyin is sort of not having any burn spells in hand because he didn't attack with the Grim Lavamancer. Played a Shockland tapped, and
yeah, he knows it's pretty safe for a while. That land is what he drew, so he still has nothing. Shocks to get the white, that's helpful.
I mean, okay, now it's a bit different because now Toyin is basically hitting for 5 this turn.
Yeah, I mean, he gets to get 3, he has a second card again. He has all the mana in the world. He's basically been flooding since turn 1.
Yep.
And that is
a lightning bolt, which... No, is it a lightning bolt? No, it's an IOK.
Inquisition.
Which... I don't think you want to be casting Inquisitions in this point.
I think let him force it.
I mean...
He's definitely going to do it. I mean...
I know he's going to do it. I just wouldn't.
Well, he doesn't know that there's only lands.
Now, even if there were only lands, yeah, I wouldn't, because the Lava Man's on the field and you're not dealing with it yet. So, you're kind of feeding the Lava Man.
This is also true. It's 2 lands, Inquisition hits nothing, and he's just basically given him cards. Which was going to happen regardless, so
yeah.
In this stage it doesn't really matter.
I think he kind of has to kill the Lava Man, so if he can. Then maybe flashback Lingering Souls. And we'll probably see a Lightning Bolt here.
Goes Bolt in response, take 2. And then starts chipping. Oh, flashback first. Get 2 more spirits. And...
Kind of needs Sordinia, or else he's not going to be in this game.
Yeah, he
alternatively, to it could just draw land.
He's got to secure the waste as well, which is terrible. I would have expected that to actually
Lava Spike. Oh. Yeah, Gavin down to anything.
Anything.
I mean, Toyed could basically breathe air at him, and he'd fall over at this point. I believe that was a brutality.
That is a brutality. Is he actually running those?
Main board? No. Is he?
No, he doesn't.
No,
have.
He's not. Then what is it?
I have no idea. And he goes. It's a burn spell. Into the face. Tahir takes it.
Wow, I was... Well, okay, I was sort of expecting this game. But
yeah,
in a vacuum, I was not expecting burn to be tokens.
Not this quickly, at least. I mean, I think that was actually very, very quick matches.
I actually still expect... Like, okay, because it's not Warrior Champion tokens, I actually think it's sort of skewed, and I don't believe that Gavin actually brought anything in his sideboard for this match. Really. Like, well, family reinforcements is just for generic aggro decks.
Yeah, that's...
Breast Alliance, the same thing, whereas, like, there's no... actual hoses for burn, no core firewalker, no leyline of sanctity.
Timely reinforcements is actually really bad in this list, just because of all the tokens. I mean, he's never going to get bodies.
Yeah.
The life was great, but.
So okay, the
don't
idea
you just
behind
run
it
more alliances instead.
Okay, so the idea behind it is basically, you want to be going intangible virtue turn 2, take a hit, your opponent has a creature, timely reinforcements turn 3. So that's what black-white tokens would be doing, but black-white tokens doesn't play Young Pyromancer and Monastery Mentor, which makes time reinforcements a lot worse. Like, generally with black-white tokens, you get a token from Butter Blossom, and maybe your opponent has 2 creatures, in which case time reinforcements are fine, you get 3 creatures and 6 life. Whereas with this, if you're playing like Young Pyro, you're going to cost time reinforcements, you're going to first get a token, and then... More often than not, you're not going to have less creatures than your opponent.
That's what I'm thinking. It's like, Blazed Alliance is still possibly alright here. Like, maybe...
I mean, Alliance is just generically good against aggro decks.
Yes.
Namely, Infect, Zoo, those type of decks.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, Sacrifice, the Escalator is really easy. You saw all these matchups. He does get his mana, so he could easily go, like, second game.
The card I was surprised not to see was actually Collective Vitality. When you mentioned, I was like, yeah, that's a good card. That would be amazing right now, but wasn't. Yeah.
Well, he opted to run Thought Seize on the sideboard instead. I don't know if like Vitality is actually better.
I think in a vacuum, Thought Seize is probably better. In this matchup, Vitality is 100 times better.
Also very interesting, there's a Rakdos Charm in the sideboard, which... Well, Does he just not play the tokens then? What happens?
Well, Rakdos Charm is mainly for exiling graveyards. But in which case, I don't see why you wouldn't just play something like Grafting His Cage? If you're worried about that type of deck.
I guess the Paramount is important.
Sure.
But anyway, so two more rounds to go, and we'll, I believe Shad will also be joining for a sit-in soon.
Yeah, that would be interesting to have, since he's sitting top and he's played against the majority of the players that are here today, and especially the ones doing well. Maybe not the same decks, so some people are running some strange things as we see Mardu tokens picked up. Well, okay, he went 2-0 to start, so that's still a really good start. And yeah, we'll see you guys in a bit.